Hey guys, this is the part 3 of our Kerala video and we are on our way to Kumarakom, which is famous for its backwaters, and I'm really really excited. Also, in part 1 we had covered Munnar, part 2 was all about Thekkady, and if you've not seen part 1 and part 2, you need to click the link mentioned above.
With some photo stops and trying to capture some other waterfalls along the way, we were in Kumarakom in roughly 3 hours travelling from Thekkady. And in no time, we're bidding adieu to whatever little hustle bustle of the city there was into the sleepy yet charming Emerald Peninsula called Kumarakom. For our stay, we chose the heritage backwater resort, Coconut Lagoon. Welcomed in traditional Kerala style and greeted with fresh coconut water, we were already feeling great about the experience that lay ahead. The beautifully designed villas and the open-air bathroom, both that at least we had experienced for the first time, only added to the whole charm. One doesn't need to do much of the thinking regarding the itinerary for travel once in Kumarakom. The resorts you choose to stay in have it all laid out like a buffet of delicious food. You just need to pick what you would like the most. From sunset cruise to cookery classes to classical dances or music to even a ride in a shikara to the oh-so-famous backwaters. You name it and there it is. Kumarakom is famous for its backwaters, and in the evening, boat rides take you into the heart of the scenic Vambanad Lake, the largest in the state. Cruising along the breeze-laden water highway, observing the beauty of the setting sun makes you lose your heart and mind of a lot of worries indeed. Once back to the resort, more entertainment awaits you, and all of it, mind you, in flavor with the tradition of the state. Stomach swelled with authentic Kerala food, we decided to call it a day. Looking forward to day two. The morning welcomed us with some rain, but that did not deter from making the most of our time in this beautiful property. Post a hearty breakfast and with it still raining, we headed out to the backwaters. Sailing along in a shikara through the enchanting backwaters of Kumarakom is sure to rob your heart. Palm-fringed narrow canals winding through the vast expanse of paddy fields and the neat tiny hamlets lined up along either sides of the canals overlooking the beautiful bed of water lilies is as close as one can get to feel the vibrant life in the countryside of God's own country. Boats, as we understood, were not only a means of livelihood but also a major source of transportation here. And there is one another world-famous fact related to Kerala and boats.
Out of the other
things that Kerala is famous for, it is also very famous for the Nehru Trophy boat race, also known as the snake boat race. It happens every year on the second Saturday of August. Well, you know what? We missed it by just a week. For any of you who is planning to visit Kerala, make sure you visit it in August so that you capture and actually witness the boat race. There are boats as big as these. This happens to be a smaller version, but the boats that actually go in the race can house 120 rowers at a time. And people who stay in Kerala or people who have actually seen the race, they say it is one of the things that you have to see when in Kerala. Happy hearts, smiling faces, and eyes wanting to capture the serenity forever, it was time for us to bid farewell to this beautiful land of Kerala. But our 5-day stay in the state had given us our answer as to why is it known as God's own country.
Because you know, from the scenes they have to offer, the beauty they have to offer, the food, the cuisine they have to offer, and most importantly, the people here, you know, they are so pure, they are so warm, they are so welcoming, that you actually realize that this is Kerala, this is God's own country, because it is as pure, as pristine, as calm, as something which belongs to God has to.
Scenic beauty, unparalleled cuisine, humble and warm people. Kerala, you were much more than a tourist destination for us. In true sense, you are the God's own country.
Hey guys, so this brings us to the end of the trilogy of our travelogue to Kerala. If you've not seen part 1 and 2, do go to our YouTube channel, Travel Along, and watch those parts.
Yes, and of course, we have promised ourselves the places that we have not explored in Kerala. We're going to cover that soon, but you also have to fulfill one promise that you are going to travel along with us, because you're going to pack your bag and come to Kerala.
Yes, and I hope you're liking our videos and you're also sharing them and you've already subscribed. If you haven't, then please subscribe and please tell our friends, your friends and family also to do, because your love and support will help us travel along a lot more.